Hello dear students, welcome to online biology bridge course class for SSLC completed students. In the yesterday's video I explained about the structure of DNA, and today let us study about what are the functions carried out by DNA. So DNA is expanded as deoxyribonucleic acid. It is made up of four main nitrogen bases: adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine and uracil. The composition of DNA, which I explained in the previous video, DNA is made up of the pentose sugar, deoxyribose sugar, and its formula C5H10O4. C5H10O4 is the formula of deoxyribose sugar. It consists of AGCT, where adenine always pairs with thymine by two hydrogen bonds and guanine pairs with cytosine by three hydrogen bonds. Let me write it properly so that four is not clear here. The chemical formula of deoxyribose sugar is C5H10O4. The number of oxygen atoms is 4. The adenine, guanine, cytosine are the nitrogen bases, where adenine pairs with thymine by two hydrogen bonds and guanine pairs with cytosine by three hydrogen bonds. Along with them, the phosphate group is also present, and the phosphate group is responsible for negative charge exerted by the DNA molecule. So let us study about what are the different functions carried out by DNA molecule. So the first function, it is the main genetic material. It is the genetic material in all organisms, including viruses also. In all the organisms, the DNA is genetic material, including viruses. The viruses are also having DNA as genetic material. So what is the meaning of genetic material, or which biomolecule is known as genetic material? Here, genetic material means the biomolecule which gives or sends messages. The biomolecule which gives the messages for other processes, it is called genetic material, and it brings the messages from parents to offsprings. Characters from parents to offsprings are brought or carried with the help of DNA, hence it is called genetic material. So in all the organisms, the main function of the DNA is genetic material. And in the yesterday's video, I explained the DNA and protein, they together form chromatin fibers, and chromatin fibers, they give rise to the formation of chromosomes. This is the first function of DNA. Then second function of the DNA is, it is able to produce its own copy. It is able to produce its own copy. That means it produces its molecules. When the old DNA molecule, which is present in the chromosome, when it produces new DNA molecule, the process is called replication, the most important function of DNA molecule. The old DNA, it produces the new DNA molecule, and this process is called replication. The DNA molecule has the ability to produce its own copy. And remember, replication of DNA, it occurs before cell division. When a cell is ready to undergo the division process, before entering into division process, the DNA makes its own copies through the process called replication. This is most important character exhibited by the DNA compared with another molecule, RNA. DNA and RNA. RNA means ribonucleic acid. DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. The DNA molecule has the ability to produce its own copy. The process is called replication, and replication occurs just before the cell division. Then another interesting function of DNA is it controls or it produces, the better term is synthesizes, it produces RNA molecules also. All the RNA molecules are also synthesized from DNA. So what I told, when new DNA is produced from old DNA, the process is called replication. The synthesis of new DNA molecule from the old DNA is called replication. Like that, when the RNA molecules are synthesized from DNA. What kind of RNA? Hope you are familiar with the terms. rRNA, expansion is ribosomal RNA. Then one more is mRNA, expansion is messenger RNA. Then tRNA, expansion is transfer RNA. So these are the three types of RNAs. They are necessary for the process of protein synthesis. From the DNA, when RNA molecules are synthesized, it is called transcription. The synthesis of RNA molecules from DNA is called transcription. Synthesis of DNA from DNA is called replication. RNA molecules are also synthesized from DNA. Another very important function, it controls protein synthesis. It controls protein synthesis. When protein molecules are synthesized in the cell, the protein synthesis is also controlled by DNA. The protein synthesis is biologically called translation, replication, transcription, and translation. These are the three important terms with reference to the functions of DNA. The DNA is acting as genetic material. It brings the messages, or it gives messages from parents to the offsprings. The better term here, instead of gives messages, it brings messages from parents to offsprings. The function of genetic material is to bring messages from the parents to offsprings. Let me write, it brings the messages from parents to offsprings. Then the old DNA produces new DNA copies. Process is known as replication, and replication occurs before cell division. DNA is acting as genetic material in all the organisms, including the viruses. New DNA molecules are synthesized from the old DNA. The process is called replication. And from DNA, RNA molecules are synthesized. It is called transcription. And it also controls protein synthesis, known as translation. All these are dependent on one another. Let me clear one more thing. So here I mentioned mRNA. M means messenger. This mRNA, it is functioning or working like a postman. So what is the function of postman? He delivers the letters to proper address. Like that, DNA, it is the genetic material. Obviously, the DNA gives messages. Whatever the messages are given by DNA, they are all received by mRNA. The messages given by DNA are received by mRNA. So this mRNA, it finally participates in the synthesis of proteins, because the messages for protein synthesis are carried by the mRNA. Using mRNA, the finally protein molecules are synthesized in the cell. The process is known as translation. And here the proteins are the biomolecules which are made up of the building blocks called amino acids. The proteins are the biomolecules made up of the building blocks called amino acids. And remember, there are 20 different types of amino acids are present, and all those amino acids are needed for the synthesis of proteins. All the messages given by the DNA are carried by only one type of RNA, and it is mRNA. That is why M stands for messenger RNA. It brings all those messages given by the DNA molecule. And remember, DNA is giving the messages for the synthesis of proteins. All the messages given by the DNA are for the function or the process called translation. According to the messages given by the DNA, the protein molecules are synthesized in the cell. This is how the messages of the DNA are used in synthesis of the proteins with the help of mRNA. Then let us know about one more term related to the structure and function of DNA. It is mutation. What is mutation? Mutation is defined as sudden change in the structure of DNA. Sudden change in the structure of DNA is called mutation. Say, for example, let us consider this is the DNA molecule. Now I am going to highlight only this part just for understanding the mutation. This is just an example. So I will highlight this particular part of the DNA. This is one chain of the DNA, and this is another chain of the DNA. So here adenine is present, thymine is present, guanine is present, and cytosine is present. According to the pairing, adenine pairs with thymine and guanine pairs with cytosine. That means this chain is having adenine. Naturally, opposite to this one, thymine is present. Here thymine is present. Opposite to thymine, only possibility is of adenine. guanine opposite cytosine and opposite to the cytosine, guanine is present. Assume this is the DNA molecule before undergoing mutation. The diagram of the DNA which I am using for the explanation, let us assume this DNA structure is before undergoing the mutation. What is the definition of mutation? What it states? Sudden change in the structure of DNA. It may happen any time. There is no specific time for the mutation. During any time the mutation can occur. And whenever mutation occurs, the structure of the DNA is suddenly changed. How to understand? This is, let us mark the nitrogen bases, first, second, third and fourth. It is the arrangement of nitrogen bases in the DNA segment before undergoing mutation. Let us assume this DNA is subjected to mutation. So what is going to happen now? Structure of the DNA changes. This is the DNA structure after mutation: A, G, T, G, C. So here is another chain, opposite to A, thymine, opposite to G, cytosine, thymine opposite adenine, guanine opposite cytosine, and cytosine opposite guanine. Look at the second nitrogen base. What happened? Here, the second position is occupied by thymine and adenine, but here the second position is occupied by guanine and cytosine. Whenever the nitrogen bases are added to the DNA or nitrogen bases are removed from the DNA, both the conditions result in mutation. And mutation is nothing but sudden change in the structure of DNA. It may be due to addition of the nitrogen base. It may be anything. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, anything may be added, but among the four. And even it is caused due to removal of nitrogen base. So both the conditions result in change in the structure of DNA molecule, and this is called mutation. Remember, mutation is very helpful process for evolution, because mutation result in the development of new organism. And whenever new organisms are developed on the earth, it is called evolution. So evolution is due to mutation, and during the mutation the change in the structure of DNA molecule occurs. It may be due to addition of the nitrogen base, or it may be due to removal of the nitrogen base. Like this, the DNA is even controlling or responsible for evolution. And whenever evolution occurs, the development of new organism is always observed, and evolution is dependent on mutation. Mutation is a process where sudden change in the structure of the DNA is observed. So what are the main functions of DNA? It acts as genetic material, brings messages from parents to the offsprings. The old DNA produces new DNA molecule or own copy. It is called replication. From the DNA, RNA molecules are synthesized. It is called transcription. And DNA gives the messages for the synthesis of proteins. It is called translation. Whenever the structure of DNA is suddenly changed, it is called mutation. And mutation is responsible for the development of new organism. The process is nothing but evolution. Hope the explained part is clear for you. Thank you.